Hey leaders, just wanted to take a minute and say Merry Christmas. I hope that you had an awesome holiday season with your family or your loved ones or however you spent it. I hope it was great. You can see I got a refresher of my favorite hat, so I'm not going to be wearing the beat up one because that was a Christmas present to me yesterday. But just wanted to take a second and encourage you to slow down before we hit 2019. I just reflect and celebrate everything that Jesus has done in your life in 2018. I know we've all had stories of personal transformation, and just thank God for what He's done in you, how He's grown you as a Christian, as a human, as a leader, as a minister. And then also thank Him for what He's done in your ministry through your small group or through relationships with students, because it's a really big deal. I want to make sure that we're people who celebrate what God has done and what God is doing. So just a reminder, there's no rush tonight, December 26th, and there's no rush next week, January 2nd. But let's take these next couple weeks and pray for our students. Let's make sure that this isn't a time where they feel forgotten about. So if you think about it, just text one of your kids, let them know that you're praying for them, you're on their team. But yeah, let's make this an intentional couple of weeks while we get some rest, while we spend some time in family, with family, and let's hit 2019 strong. So please, please, please spend some time praying for your students, and also be on the lookout because I'm going to be making a little guide for what we as a team and as a student ministry can be praying for this year in the week of prayer and fasting starting on January 7th. All right. Love you guys. Greetings from Washington, by the way. This is a place where houses aren't made with bricks. They're made with wood. So God bless you, and we'll see you guys when we get back. Love you. Bye.